Jesus Christ have received faith as precious as ours. Verse 2, the Bible says, grace and peace be multiplied through the knowledge of our God and of Jesus our Lord. According to his divine power, he has given us everything that pertaineth to godliness and life through the knowledge of him who has called us to his own glory and goodness. And verse 4, the Bible says, through this he has given us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through this we might be partakers of divine nature, escaping the corruption that is in this world through lust. Hallelujah. Amen. We want you to understand and know that the people that Simon or Peter was addressing were people who had obtained the like precious faith that the apostles had. So this letter is addressed to people of faith. And as we have been saying, that faith is a fundamental requirement for us to experience the life that God has ordained for us. For us to walk in that nature that God created us to, we have to be people of faith. So this letter is addressed to the people of faith, the precious faith which the apostles also had. And there are things that Peter is saying after addressing his letter to the people of faith. In verse 2, the Bible says that he tells them that grace and peace be multiplied to you. Grace and peace be multiplied to you through the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ. I want us to understand also that a multiplication of grace and peace in our lives as we live this life of faith will come through the knowledge of God and of Jesus Christ. So it is the knowledge of God and of our Lord Jesus Christ which shall cause a multiplication of grace and peace. We all know the Bible says that God has dealt with everyone a measure of faith. But this faith should be multiplied. It should increase. It should not only remain at that level of a measure. No. The Bible here opens our understanding that this peace and this grace should be multiplied. And the multiplication will only come as a result of knowledge. So it is knowledge that shall cause a multiplication. The knowledge of God and the knowledge of Jesus Christ. Verse 3, the Bible says that according to his divine power, he has given us, according to his divine power, he has given unto us all things that pertains to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who have called us to glory and to virtue. It is also that when we were called, God has given us all things that pertains to life and to godliness. But these things, we will only receive them through the knowledge. I am emphasizing on the word through knowledge, because it is the channel, it is the way, it is the only channel that God will use to multiply his grace and his peace upon our lives. It is through the knowledge of God and Jesus Christ. And these things also which have been given to us that pertaineth life and godliness according to the divine power of God. The Bible also says that these things will come to us through the knowledge of Him who have called us into glory and to virtue. So I want to lay this foundation and in the minds, in our minds, that let us know and understand that if there is anything that is going to happen in our lives pertaining the grace of God, pertaining the peace of God, and pertaining everything, the Bible says He has given. They are already given to us. But we have to receive whatever that has been given to us. We are on the end of receiving. We as recipients, we must receive so that whatever has been given to us might be of profit to us. But the only way for us to receive the peace, the grace, and everything that pertains to life and godliness, it is through the knowledge. So it is knowledge that will transport whatever we have. It is knowledge that will transform our lives. And that is why, if you read in the book of Matthew 22 from verse 29, Matthew 22 verse 29, the Bible, Jesus responding to the Pharisees and saying to them, "You do error not knowing the scripture and the power of God." You do error. You go astray. You miss the mark. You miss whatever that is already given to you, not because that it is not there, but because of lack of knowledge of the scripture and of the power of God. You go astray, you err, you miss whatever is yours, ordained and prepared and given. You miss it because of lack of knowledge. You do err, Jesus said. And in Isaiah verse 5, chapter 5 verse 13, Isaiah, God speaks to His people and says that therefore my people are taken into captivity because of lack of knowledge. My people are taken into captivity because of lack of knowledge. In other words, you may find yourself being a captive of things that you are not supposed to be a captive of. You are a prisoner of things that already God has delivered you from. You are bound by things that are not supposed to bound you. Or you are experiencing some situations which you are not supposed to experience. But because of lack of knowledge, that is why you are experiencing those things. But now I want to believe that these things that have been given to us, they are already given to us. The peace that has been given to us, the grace that has been given to us, and all things that pertain to life and to godliness, it is by true knowledge that we will receive these things. And we shall not continue to err in the name of Jesus Christ. We shall not continue in captivity in Jesus' name, because the knowledge of God is coming to our lives in Jesus' name. Hosea chapter 4 verse 6. The Bible says, concerning God, speaking about His people, and He's saying, "My people perish. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. And because you have rejected knowledge, I have also rejected you. And I have rejected also your children. And I have rejected that you shall not be my priests." My people perish. They tell us that word perish does not mean as such as destruction. No, it means that they are deprived. It means they are being deprived. So we can put it this way, that my people are deprived of their peace. They are deprived of the grace of God in their life. They are deprived of all those things that pertain to life and godliness which I have given to them. It is already given, but now, because of lack of knowledge, they have been deprived. That word deprived also means to be stripped off. These things have been taken away from them. Though these things belong to them, though these things are legally theirs, but because of lack of knowledge, these things have been stripped away from them. And this is what the enemy uses. He uses ignorance, because we are also told that in the land that ignorance is not a defense. You cannot say, I didn't know. Whether you knew or you don't know, you will be striped. You will be deprived of your rights. You will be deprived of what belongs to you because of lack of knowledge. Grace and peace be multiplied to you through the knowledge. Hallelujah. And all these things, according to his divine power, that have been given to us, but they have been given to us through knowledge. It is knowledge that we shall be partakers of these things. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that he has given us all things. All things have been, oh my God, the Lord help us. All things have been given. They have been already been given to us. And I have said that it is up to us who have been given to receive. Unless we receive, we cannot enjoy these things. And these things, we will only receive them through knowledge of our God and our Lord Jesus Christ, through the knowledge of him who has called us. If you read in Luke 12 verse 32, the Bible says that it is given to us the kingdom. Take pleasure. Hallelujah. Be of good pleasure, for it is your Father's pleasure. Hallelujah. To give us the kingdom. The kingdom has been given to us. So we are supposed to take pleasure, knowing that the kingdom has been given to us. Yet, though the kingdom has been given to us, we have to take that kingdom. Hallelujah. We have to take that kingdom. So we are in the kingdom. We have been given the kingdom. Matthew 13 verse 11. The Bible says that in that kingdom, hallelujah, in that kingdom, we have been granted to know. It has been granted unto us in that kingdom to know the mysteries of the kingdom. It has been granted. It has been given to us to know the mysteries of the kingdom. And what are these mysteries? These mysteries, the Bible says that they have been hidden to the wise and to the prudent, but unto us they have been revealed. It has been granted to us to know the mysteries of the kingdom. And now we are already given the kingdom. And the knowledge of the ministry of the mysteries of the kingdom is there for us to take. If the mysteries of the kingdom is there to take, now Matthew 16:17-19, the Bible says that you have been given the keys. Amen. The keys to the kingdom. The kingdom has been given unto us. The knowledge of the mysteries of the kingdom has been granted unto us. Now we are in the kingdom. Now we have the keys. We have the keys of the kingdom. So that Matthew 6:33, Jesus said concerning those who are worried, hallelujah, of what they will eat and what they will drink and what they will wear. And he reasoned in this manner, and he said to them, why are you troubled concerning what you will eat and what will you drink? Let me ask you a question. What is more important? What to eat or what to drink or life? Life compared to what you will eat and what you will drink. What is more important? And Jesus responded to them and told them, life is more important than what you should eat and what you should drink. So if God, your Father, has given you life, then he is able to give you what you will eat and what you will drink. And he asked them also, what is more important, a body or the clothes that you put upon the body? And Jesus answered and responded to them that a body is more important than clothes, because you can have what to eat and have what to drink and lack life and miss life, and you don't have life. So these things that you are seeking to drink and to eat, they become irrelevant because you don't have life. But if you have life, God will give you what to eat and what to drink. And he also said that the body is more important. The God who has given you the body, he will give you what to put on that body. And so Jesus told them, Stop worrying, because these things, the Gentiles are after them. But your Father knows that you are in need of these things. And so, because now it is the pleasure of your Father to give you the kingdom, and it is his pleasure also, he has given you the keys of the kingdom. And now he's saying, seek ye first. Seek ye first. You have been granted. You have been given the kingdom. You have been given the kingdom. The knowledge of the kingdom is granted unto you. You have the keys of the kingdom. And now you are being told, seek first the kingdom. And these other things, these things that have been given, they shall be added unto you. Seek first the kingdom. Seek first the kingdom. And all these things shall be added unto you. And let me tell you, you are not supposed to remain at that particular juncture where only things are added. So whenever you come before God, whenever you come before the presence of God, and you are seeking God, you have a right to tell God, now Father, I've been in your presence, and you promised that these things shall be added. Now add whatever that you have given unto me that pertaineth to life and godliness. Add, it is an addition. But I want us to shift from that addition, that we may go to
multiplication.
Hallelujah. These things shall be multiplied through the knowledge. Hallelujah. And apart from multiplication, hallelujah, the Bible says in Matthew 11 verse 12 that since the days of John the Baptist, the kingdom suffered violence. And the violence take it by force. Now we are told that the King James is the English of 1611, kind of. Hallelujah. And the word suffer in our day means allow. It allows. So the kingdom allows. Hallelujah. The kingdom allows violence. And the violent take it forcefully. In other words, we will shift from being given and being added to the position of taking now. Taking, hallelujah. From being given, from seeking, from additional, from multiplication, to now take. We take these things that have been given to us that pertain to life and godliness. The kingdom allows those who are violent to take them by force, to forcefully take.
Amen.
Forcefully. You can take whatever you want in the kingdom in the name of Jesus. It is your force of your faith that will determine what will come to you. It is allowed in this kingdom to take things forcefully. And these things are taken forcefully through the knowledge. We take them forcefully through the knowledge. The knowledge of sowing. The knowledge of offering. The knowledge of sacrificing. You see, when you sow seeds and name those seeds toward a particular thing, you are not waiting to be given. You are not waiting for addition or multiplication. You are forcefully taking, sacrificially. When you lay your Isaac upon the altar, God will give back your Isaac multiplied, but it is not being given. It is taking. The forceful will take with their gifts, with their sacrifice, and with your seed in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that call unto me, hallelujah, and I will answer you. Show you Jeremiah 3 from verse 1. Call unto me, and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things that you know not. Great and there are things prepared. That is what the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verse 9 and 10. That ears have not heard, eyes have not seen, neither these things have entered into the hearts of men, the things that God have prepared for us who love him. Hallelujah. And we have remained in that particular point that things that have not been heard, they have not been seen, they have not entered. But verse 10, the Bible says that, but these things, they have been revealed. These things, they are not a mystery anymore. These things, they are not a preparation for us anymore. These things have been revealed to us through the Holy Spirit. They have been revealed to us. And the Bible says that the Holy Spirit was given to us that we might know the things that are freely given to us to enjoy in life, the things that pertain to life and godliness. Hallelujah. The knowledge of these things through the Holy Spirit, we will receive them. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Oh, the Bible says that. Verse 4. He has given us, according to his divine power, given unto us exceedingly precious and are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises. Promises are given to us. Now, these promises are not for receiving. Hallelujah. Things that pertain to life and godliness. The things that pertain to life and godliness, we have received them through the knowledge. Hallelujah. So we have these things. We have already received them. But the Bible says that according to his divine power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, through this, hallelujah, exceedingly great and precious promises that have been given unto us, that we might be partakers of divine nature. That we might be partakers of divine nature. The things that pertain to life and godliness have already been given to us, and we will receive them through the knowledge of him who has called us. But now we go into another dimension, the dimension of the nature of the life that we carry. The dimension of the life that we carry. The Bible says that these great and precious promises have been given to us that we might become partakers of divine nature. Partakers of divine nature. Divine nature. The Bible says that these promises is the word of God. These promises is the word of God. And in the beginning, hallelujah, there was the word. And the word was God. The word was with God. And the word was God. Hallelujah. And when God spoke to creation in Genesis 1, 24 and 25, he commanded every living creature to bring forth according to its kind. According to its kind. And now, the word of God, the Bible says in 1 Peter 1:23, that we being born again, hallelujah, not of the corruptible seed, but the incorruptible seed of the word of God. We have been born again, because in the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God, and everything brings according to its kind. And so we are, the Bible says in 1 John 1 verse 12 and 13, that we are not born of the will of man, nor the will of flesh, nor the will of blood, but by the will of God we are sons. We have become children of God. We are born of God. We are born of God. In other words, the nature of the life that we carry is the nature of the life of God, the eternal life, the Zoe life. You have heard of the kind, the faith kind of God. Now we are talking the very life of God. We have been made partakers of that life. And because we have been made partakers of that life, the kind, the God kind of life, hallelujah, the God kind of life, the soul life, the eternal life. The Bible says this life cannot be corrupted, hallelujah. We have escaped the corruption. In other words, the word corruption means perversion. Perversion is against what is right and what is straight. So we have escaped corruption. We have escaped perversion according to the nature of the life that we carry, the life of God. The Bible says this life cannot be molested by the weakening, beggarly elements of this world. COVID-19 is an element of this world. It cannot corrupt our bodies, for our life that we carry is the eternal life, the God life, hallelujah. Oh, and because of the enormity of the power of the life that we carry, whatever that is perverse, we have escaped. We have escaped AIDS. We have escaped COVID-19. We have escaped poverty. We have escaped curses. We have escaped whatever is perverse that is of this world because of the life that we carry. This life is hid in Christ Jesus at the right hand of God the Father. Above all, above all principalities, above all powers, above all wickedness, above all diseases, above cancer, hallelujah. This life, the higher life, is above. Oh, these other things, because it is the divine nature, the very life of God. Father, we thank you. We bless you. We give you glory. Thank you for your word, which is your seed, my God, that we have been born of. For every kind brings forth according to its kind. And we are born of God. We escape every perversion, every corruption that in this world, oh God, because of the enormity of the life that we carry, bacteria, bad bacteria, and germs and viruses cannot come close to our bodies, to our lives, in the name of Jesus. 1,000 shall fall on our left hand, 10,000 shall fall in our right hand, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, for you have given us all things that pertain to life and godliness through your knowledge. We thank you, for they are our portion. We receive them. We take them forcefully. In the name of Jesus, we thank you and we bless you. Amen and amen.